Hello and welcome to Design Patterns. Today we'll talk about the leader-follower. We just talked about the master-slave pattern before, and now leader-follower will tie into this thought school, so to say. Because the leader-follower, the core idea of leader-follower is we have multiple executors, and these take turns in processing tasks. So when you think of master-slave, there we had this coordinator, and the coordinator was distributing tasks onto the slaves, onto the workers. Here we have the worker's self, and it works by just the next who is the current leader will just take the next task, and then they swap roles. So the next follower will become the next leader. So this is basically this is the idea behind thread pools, behind background workers, and so on. The difference to the master-slave is that we don't have a dedicated coordinator who does just the coordination, so the distribution and the collection of the results, but the threads themselves just take turns in executing the tasks. So let me give you a real-life example. Master-slave is kind of a coordinator is going in parallel to the slaves in leader-follower. The first one is the leader and goes in line with all the followers.